Our 10th problem is a very important problem which is similar to the problem in a sense to the earlier problem. We are given that if S1 and S are the foci of the ellipse and P to be any general point of the ellipse and E is the eccentricity of the ellipse, x square by a square plus y square by b square equal to 1, then we need to prove that tan of angle PSS1 by 2 into tan of angle PS1S by 2 is equal to 1 minus E upon 1 plus E. Now, as we did in the 9th problem, let us make the figure. This is point P, A cos theta, comma B sin theta. This is S1 minus AE, comma 0. This is S, AE, comma 0. The length this is equal to 1 minus E cos theta, as we proved earlier. This is 2AE and this is A times 1 plus E cos theta. This will be equal to the y coordinate of point P, since these points S1 and S are lying on the x axis. So this is equal to B sin theta. So from over here we can get tan of PS1S is equal to tan of PS1S, if this is the coordinate axis, this is 0, 0. So we have tan of PS1S is equal to this upon this length. This is equal to the x coordinate, that is A cos theta, and this is equal to AE. So tan of PS1S becomes B sin theta upon A cos theta plus AE, that is A times cos theta plus E. And tan of PSS1 comes out to be equal to this entire length is AE. Mind you, this AE and this AE are appearing to be different in lengths, but they are not. This is also equal to AE and this is also equal to AE. This is, so tan of this angle is equal to B sin theta upon AE minus A cos theta. So this is equal to E minus cos theta. Now we have got the tan of PS1S and PSS1, and we want to find the tan of PS1S by 2 and PSS1 by 2. So we know that tan of theta by 2 is equal to 1 minus cos theta upon 1 plus cos theta under root. This is equal to 1 minus cos theta. On multiplying 1 minus cos theta on both sides, this becomes 1 minus cos theta whole square upon 1 minus cos square theta, which is sin square theta. So this under root becomes 1 minus cos theta by sin theta. And hence, tan of PS1S by 2 is equal to 1 minus tan of PSS1, or rather 1 minus cos of PSS1, PS1S, I am sorry, divided by sine of PS1S. We don't require this figure anymore. Now this is tan of PS1S. So we can find sine of PS1S is equal to B sin theta upon under root of B sin theta whole square plus A times cos theta plus E whole square. Making the figure once again, we see that if this is P, this is S1, and this is S, this is B sin theta, the sine of PS1S will be equal to B sin theta upon under root of this, or we can write this as perpendicular upon hypotenuse, and this was equal to A times 1 plus E cos theta. So we can write it as B sin theta upon A times 1 plus E cos theta. Cos of PS1S becomes equal to A times cos theta plus E upon this length again, A times 1 plus E cos theta. So tan of PS1 S by 2 is equal to 1 minus cos of this angle. That is 1 minus this a and a gets cancelled. This becomes cos theta plus e upon 1 plus e cos theta whole divided by b sin theta upon a times 1 plus e cos theta. This is a problem which is entirely based on the geometry of the triangle PS1S. Hence, on solving this, we get tan of PS1S by 2 to be equal to A into 1 minus E into 1 minus cos theta upon B sin theta. Doing the problem in the similar fashion, we can find out tan of PSS1 by 2 to be equal to A into 1 minus E into 1 plus cos theta upon B sin theta. Now we need to find the product of tan of PS1S by 2 and tan of PSS1 by 2. The product comes out to be equal to A square times 1 minus E whole square into 1 minus cos square theta, that is sin square theta, upon B square sin square theta. This sin square theta and sin square theta gets cancelled. So we have 1 minus E whole square divided by B square by A square. And for an ellipse, we know that B square by A square is equal to 1 minus E square. So this is 1 minus E square. Cancelling the factor of 1 minus E, this comes out to be equal to 1 minus E upon 1 plus E, which we needed to prove. And hence, we have seen that this was a very important problem since it required certain knowledge of geometry of the triangle PS1S, where P is any general point on the ellipse. S1 and S are the two foci of the ellipse, x square by a square plus y square by b square is equal to 1. So, doing the entire problem using trigonometric knowledge and the knowledge of analytical geometry, we have tan of PSS1 by 2 into tan of PS1S by 2 proved to be equal to 1 minus E upon 1 plus E.